What is up, guys? Playing another League of Legends ranked game. Today we're playing Heartseeker Ashe. I forgot the skin name, but I remember now. Heartseeker Ashe. I've already done a video with this, but just wanted to make a video, and this is the role I got, so I was like, whatever, I'll do it. Hopefully it doesn't bore you guys half to death. And this game, I've got some music playing in the background, so I need your opinion on that. If you guys decide you don't like it, you know, I'll make sure it's not super loud so that, like, you can't hear anything else, but I think maybe it helps keep it a little more entertaining. So, see how it goes. So Heartseeker Ashe, or Ashe in general, is a really good champion, but she's kind of outdated, you know. She hadn't had any buffs or debuffs in a while, and she's just one of those champs that you don't see a whole lot, and she can do really, really well, or she can do really, really badly. Play it off. Play it off. Well. Yeah, well, Vi has no flash, so whoops. Somebody asked me a pretty good question. They said, what do you think is the best role to carry yourself out of bronze and silver elo? If you truly believe that, you know, you deserve to be in a better elo than you're in, you got placed badly, or you know, what have you. I think honestly that there's a couple answers. You know, it's gonna be different people are gonna have different opinions, but I personally think that jungle is probably number one, and I'll tell you why in a second. I think AD carry is number two. Come on, Vi, attack the hello. Okay, that's all you get, girl. I think jungle is number one, and AD carry is number two. Reason being, in low elo, if you're a really, really good jungler, you can counter jungle, you know when and where to be, and you can steal the enemy's buffs, and put their jungler behind, and almost make them somewhat irrelevant, and give them a hard time getting them, getting to a point where they're going to be strong, and that is really, really good. I mean, in lane, as AD carry or support or mid or whatever, you can do the same thing, but that relies on you getting a kill, putting your person behind, putting your opponent behind, what was I gonna say, and pushing the wave effectively and smartly so that they miss more creeps, blah, blah, blah. And so, with jungle, you don't really have that. You have, you know, you have your half of the jungle and the opponent's half of the jungle. And if you're a good jungler, you can do what is necessary to take their jungle and keep them behind. Oh, wow. The siege minion actually took my volley, so I didn't get the damage off, but it's okay. Still pretty good play. We got free damage. Missed this. Ooh. No! Okay, I almost missed that siege. I need to watch out. She's gonna try to bubble me. Thresh, stop it. Stop it. Okay, now I'm gonna walk away. So I can, that's no good. Stop it, fish. Thresh just went a little too ham there, and I don't do much damage early on. Not that he was necessarily trying to get a kill, but we can't afford to go quite that ham yet. Should be able to get this. Yes. I don't have enough damage. I can get this one up. No, I can't. Dang. Go ahead and pop my potion. Jinx, no flash. I think. I might have missed that. So Thresh should probably try to go back, because right now, yeah, that hook. Come on, man. Right now he's so low, he can't be in range to do anything. And he's just going to sit back and not really do much and be not not really super useful. So I feel like you should probably go back and buy some potions. Oh my god, I miss that siege. I still have both my summoners, so I'm not, I mean, I'm in danger, but I still have those, so. Don't have the damage for this. Ugh. Looks like Vi's coming in to try to make something happen. Okay, I got more of this, so. I'm actually going to be, let's see, how are we doing on creeps? 23 to my 24, but I'm leaving lane earlier, so. That's not too bad, considering I don't want the creep score very well. I don't creep score very well when I'm talking, so. Chris just needs to be safe. Let's see. He started coin, so every time a minion dies near him, he's going to gain a little bit of health back. So, assuming he can stay back and just regen some of that health from minions dying around him, he should be okay. But eating bubbles like that, it's not going to wind up in his favor. And I've yet to see him land a hook. Okay, so now that I've been back and she hasn't, I'm actually a little bit stronger than her. I missed that siege. There's no way I could get it. I don't have the damage for it. I did okay there.
Stand together.
I keep maxing. I keep leveling my Q instead of my W, so that's not good at all. Because you don't want to max your Q at all. That hook, man. Come on. That was a bad hook. So I'll go ahead and throw a ward out here. A regular, an actual ward. That's going to keep me with vision for a little while. I think maybe Nami went back. If Nami did go back, then we want to shove. Because positioning-wise, she didn't go back. But if we can get it to where it's Jinx pinned against the tower, it's actually favorable for us because she will miss creeps, kind of like I have been missing. And, man, you were... What was that lantern? Anyway, so, jungle, I feel like has a really strong potential for carrying, because if you do well, and you, you do well as a jungler, you can, and you know what you're doing, you can take the enemy jungler and basically make one person on their team not really worth a hoot. So that's a big deal. Thresh hooking the hell out of that creep. So I don't really, this is kind of a boring lane so far. That she's not being super aggressive, but neither are we. Is fine. We actually have pretty similar ults, so that'd be interesting. Hers travels faster and does more damage, though, so that's not good. And I did hit 6 before her, but I don't think that we have the potential to all in here, especially with this Thresh missing lots of hooks. Does not bode well for us. We have a really small creep wave here, so probably don't want to do anything too crazy. I did pick up those, I did go back early to get those boots because Ashe is a very slow champion, and what? That wasn't even close. Okay. Ah, shit! That one got me. Did I get the siege? I didn't see. We're actually in a favorable position, but this Thresh is not connecting a lot, so that's unfortunate. You know, that's another thing about, like, which lane can carry best. If you, even if you're a really, really, really good player, and you have a bad support, like, awful, it's very hard to get ahead, so, because you're, even if you, like, what was that? Even if you never die in your lane, if you're, if your support dies a lot, your AD, the opposing AD here, you can still get that, which is a big deal. You obviously don't want that. So, AD carry, I think, is probably a little bit harder than jungle to carry with, but if you know what to do late game and where to push and where to be, it still helps, but your laning phase can be... oh, my god. Oh. Alright, dropping the ult. This is going to be a kill on Nami. Damn it. Okay, well, she flashed and healed, so that works out for us. Good job, Thresh. He landed that box, or he hit the box, but it did not connect with Jinx because she flashed out of it. But all in all, good play. I blew my flash. Thresh eating a zap. We can honestly dragon off of this, but I don't think we'd be able to convince Vi to help, honestly. So that's one thing. Oh, and again, you know, as a jungler, you have the option to take objectives. You know, if you're bottom lane or your mid lane or whatever, and you just straight up leave your lane, your lane opponent is gonna do something with that. You know, they're gonna push your tower or roam and get kills or something like that. As a jungler, you don't really have an assigned area. You know, you could be anywhere in here. So, stopping to go take dragon or something like that early on can make a huge difference in your team and your team gold, and that's what it's all about. So, to answer the question in 10,000 words or less, I think jungle is the best carry lane. Oh, let's talk about our team comp real quick. Akali mid, Vi jungle, Malphite top, Thresh support, Ashe AD carry, Sion jungle, Katarina mid, Olaf top, Jinx AD carry, and Nami support. And not trying to get any sort of kills here, just providing that hook. Oh my god. This guy he's not doing so well. On the bright side, he I didn't even realize it was still there. He wanted to AD carry, or he said, I can AD carry or support, I'm good at both. Thank god I chose AD carry. Typically, I mean, if you get the choice, that's what I'm gonna pick. She got a BF sword. She has pretty much the same build as I do. But she has a dagger. Another dagger. Or a dagger, sorry. As opposed to a second Doran. So my lane sustain is going to be a little bit greater than hers. Except that she has the fish. The fish heals. Whoops. Oh, this team was like... When I picked Ashe, they were like, no! No! Wait. There's a pink in there. Big deal. Because apparently they don't think Ashe has the potential to do anything. But I'm here to tell you, she certainly does. Any champ has the potential to do anything. As long as you know how to play it. Like, but if you're constantly hooking creeps... Do this, Thresh. Yes! Yes! Okay. Thresh died, but I could give two shits about Thresh. Bye, dragon. I would rather get dragon than a turret, because I'm doing well in lane. If they were, like, destroying us in lane, I would want to try to take that tower and maybe roam. But because laning phase, I feel like it's going pretty well. My creep score, I have 97, Jinx is 82, and I'm 2-0. So I'm actually doing pretty well, I feel, in the lane phase. So I don't want to rush ending it. Plus, I mean, I guess either one gives you lane gold, so whatever. So push this wave, and then I'm gonna go back. No, I'm not. I'm gonna take this way. Because I want this. I want these minions to get to the tower and die. Before Jinx has a chance to get them. Sorry, guys. A little bit of a sneeze there. So, I play Jinx a whole lot, so I know if Jinx is sitting in rocket mode, she's scared. Oh, I probably shouldn't be here. I'm gonna step a little bit closer. So, I had lots of gold, and I've come back a lot stronger to lane, and what did she get? She got Berserker's Grief, so when I come back to lane, how much is this? Actually, I think I need, let's see, 1375. So, my potions? And there we go. IE at 15 minutes. Not really the best, you know. You can get IE a lot sooner. I think I've had it, like, the best I ever did is around 9 minutes or so, but that was, like, an unfair stomp. So, IE at 15 minutes, not too bad. Got IE. So now I know with what she's got, a BF Sword and Berserker's Griefs, she's going to attack faster than me, but she's going to hit for a lot less, and she has no crit chance as opposed to mine. So, hook. Hook, man. Hook, man. Hook. Okay. Don't hook. This dude. Put some words. Word, Thresh. Thank you, Thresh. You're my friend. We're going to ping Mia. I don't know where they... Oh, wow. They're just sitting here. Afraid, I guess. Thank you for the lantern. What the hell was that ult? Oh. Oh, I popped my heal trying to save,
Really?
Popped my heal trying to save Thresh, but it was just not enough. So, it's alright. The fish is low. And I'm not gonna follow. I'm gonna sit here and farm because I'm already ahead. I don't know. I don't have an honest, good reason for that. But unfortunately, Jinx just picked up a kill. But lots of stuff going on. And meanwhile, while all that shit's going on, I'm gonna take this tower. Or maybe hurt it, because I don't attack very fast. So all that experience that just got, all those minions that just got killed by the tower, that's experience that Jinx missed, and she can't afford to miss any experience, as far behind as she is, so, oh no shit, take the tower, oh, what do you think I was doing, I missed that siege. So, that answers that question, but I will tell you in low elo, if you're playing, jungle, and you're kind of splitting and focusing on objectives rather than kills, your team is going to probably rage at you. Like, the last game I played, I got yelled at so hard. I think my overall score, I was playing Warwick Jungle, my overall score was like 4-1-8 or something like that. It wasn't a great score. However, I soloed two dragons. I soloed two dragons, took two inner turrets by myself. I took this turret and this turret by myself. And the team was just like, group, fucking group, idiot. They didn't understand what I was doing. What I was doing was creating pressure. Because if the whole team's grouping up, unless your team's getting slaughtered, you can kind of afford to push out other objectives and go after other objectives. You know, if your team's just losing really horribly and they absolutely need you, it makes more sense for you to go and help. But it kind of just depends on the situation, but be prepared for your team to rage at you. But at the same time, it's kind of a, oh, I need to be careful for her. It's kind of catch-22, so to speak, because if you are split-pushing or whatever, and you're missing, you're not getting anything out of it, then you're not really helping. But so you have to be able to effectively split push and make things happen. So Jake's got that turret, and I probably should just go do something about her. She's kind of an issue. She's just going to continue to push that turret, probably. We have, like, no ranged abilities other than myself, so that's not good. I'm kind of worried for Sion's super crazy ult. Dragon's up in 18 seconds. So hopefully the team can defend that, because I'm going to take these creeps. And, yeah, I'm going to miss those. Sion looks pissed. I want to ult, but I don't know when to do so. Oh, nice. Nice. Oh, I didn't realize I was tanking that shit. Oh god. Oh god! Man, that was a bait. Pretty solid bait on their side, so. I need red buff. Red buff would benefit me. Bro! Get off my tower, bro! This fish. Ballsy. Fortunately, Nami's skill shots are pretty easy to dodge. So they're gonna go after Dragon, the enemy team. And I could, like, probably flash kill her, but it's not worth it. We'll get this tower. Actually, she had flash, so. Throw my W in here to try to give some CC to the group. And I'm gonna kite, stay back as much as possible. I don't want to focus Sion, obviously. But, right there I just saved Thresh. I don't know if you saw that. But, I don't want to focus Sion, because he's a super tank. However, as AD carry, it's not your job. It's not your job to kill the other AD carry or whatever. It's your job to shoot whoever's closest, because if you you have to stay safe, is the number one thing. You can't just go after anybody, because if I had, like, joined into the fight right there, I'm so squishy, they could just turn around and melt me, like, instantly. So we're probably gonna lose this tower, which is no good, but all is not lost. I'm gonna sell one of these, pick up the other half of my static shield, because the Avarice Blade is just a super awesome item. Gives you that extra gold income, and Ashe is somebody who really, really, really benefits from that. So, I probably shouldn't be grouping. The reason I say that is I feel like they have a better, they may not even have a better team comp, but they have a better, they're doing better in team fights, so. If I can split separate goals, that might help, but it's kind of one of those risky business things. We have no idea where they are. They did get that dragon. Okay, so two mid, three, one top. Stand together. So I can probably safely push this wave and then retreat. Uh-oh, heard that noise. Sion came out of nowhere. So because I know that there's at least, oh, hi Jinx. I don't know if she can beat me on a one-on-one. She sure can try. Heh heh. I need to not be hanging around here, because it would be very easy for one of them to roam. And so our siege is actually not weak, because we have a Malphite and a Vi. But they're not playing their champs aggressively like those champs are meant to be played, and they're... What? Like, what? Okay. Yeah, so our team isn't doing super well, but hopefully we can still pull a win out of this. And I'm gonna take blue, because as you've seen in all my other videos, I'm an asshole. I don't care that I don't need blue as Ashe. If it's just sitting there, I'm gonna take it. That was the most awful kiting ever, right there. So I can actually go pick up my, static shiv. I'm gonna do that. I was gonna say, but, and then I realized there is no but. Okay, so static shiv is pretty good. Give me a little bit of movement speed, help slow-ass Ashe move around faster, which is nice. My creep score is rapidly deteriorating compared to the time frame, so that's no good. I still have the highest in the game, but my lead is falling off, I feel like. Well, they used two ults and I used my flash, so I don't know if it was which way it was worth, but I'm coming around the slow way. Okay, well, Olaf's just gonna chase me down and kill me, because I had nowhere to go. That's unfortunate. Our team just absolutely fell apart. Even though they wasted like three ults right off the bat, we were not able to get anything. So, team just kind of fell apart, fell to bits, even though we're equally as tanky, and I'm a little bit stronger than their AD carry. It just didn't work. So I'm gonna pick up early home guards, and I like to do that a lot if I'm winning or if I'm losing. Actually, either way, because typically my farm will be a little bit better than. Hopefully he dies so I can get Jinx. Yes. So actually, Sion's dead, so we can push that out. Honestly, we could think about getting Baron, but. I need to go protect this tower because it's going to die if I don't go to it. Anyways, I like to get the home guard boots early because my farm is usually good enough to kind of lose the money, and it lets me be more active in the game and take more objectives in a smaller time span. The team is still fighting, so let's see how it's going. They're gonna get that tower, so good job, team. My ult actually hit Sion's corpse, so it didn't do anything. Oh shit. So I got Olaf pretty low, but not low enough to where I feel like face checking that bush and possibly dying. So it's unfortunate. Definitely gonna be picking up the Last Whisper this game. They have lots and lots of tankiness on their team, so that will be my next item, and hopefully we'll end up pulling a win out of this one. Ah, it's nothing personal, Wolves, but you're worth cash. Worth the cheddar. They did just take dragon. Go away from me, fish. Oh my god, he landed the hook. Oh, nice box, nice box. Oh, I'm just gonna chill in there and wait for it to wear off. And I'm going to stay in the background, do as much damage as I can to whoever's closest to me. That's all that's important. If I run in to the fray of things to try to get to the squishy person, I'm gonna wind up dying. So an AD carry that focuses the tank is worth a lot more than an AD carry that runs in, tries to kill the squishy AP carry, AD carry on the enemy team, and is dead. So keep that in mind. Yes. Yours. You can probably get this end-hit turret as well. And then we can back off. I don't know if we can get a Baron off of this. I'll be back too soon. We can rotate up, get that tower, and that'll be worth more than Baron. Oh, Baron. I'm gonna attack move this. Try to create some distance while taking the objective. So really, really good push. Strong push on our team. Good job, everyone. So that's awesome. I'll be able to pick up my last Whisper completely outright. Don't go over in there, dude. They're gonna check that bush. Hopefully they're not gonna try to bear it. Nope, they're just checking. Oh, they're gonna try to take it. I'm still gonna go V. They don't have their AD carry, so it's gonna take them a second. Yeah, they backed off a bit. So I'm gonna take red without even asking, because, you know, that's kind of my playstyle. So that was a really, really solid play on the entire team. I caught Nami out. I used my ult on her, but which is kind of silly because she has a support. However, oh shit, I need back up. Now, that damage. Holy cow. I'm surprised at that. We do now have super minions sieging, pushing in on this tower, so that's cool. Don't ping me to be careful. I know what I'm doing. I'm a real boy. I'm totally gonna take this too. Because I'm an asshole. I'm an asshole. There's no doubt. Light a fire and pee it out. I don't know what that's from. If you can tell me, I'll give you $10 worth of RP. I'm serious. I have no idea. So I'm gonna go back. I'm gonna sell my potions, and I will get a vampire scepter, giving me a little bit more lifesteal. And sustain. And we will go back to mid lane. So, game is pretty even. 234 to 209, so I'm a little bit ahead of Vinx, but nothing crazy. And I can just clear these waves like nothing. That ult, he had no idea what to do. That was funny. He missed, and that was it. Throwing the ult out. Hitting Olaf with it, not necessarily who I wanted to hit, but... Ah! Okay, well, the team once again fell apart, but I was on a killing spree. They might actually end it right there, so yikes. They don't have a minion wave yet, but they do have some tanky people. I don't think they can end it just based on how many, how low they are. Executed! That's funny. Well, they're hungry for a win, huh? Hmm. I'll just go ahead and pick up the consumables, assuming that this is going to be the last fight of the game. Man, I'm slow even with freaking home guards. That was scary. They just took our mid inhibitors, or our inhibitors, so if we try to take Baron, they can... Minions. I don't know if this is a good idea. I'm actually stumped. But I'll help, anyways. Oh, now they know. That's great. There was a fucking sight word there, and you guys started Baron? Okay. Even with a sight word, there, we started it. So, awkward. So we need to go back and be in defense mode because they are going to push mid because they just saw us take Baron. So hopefully, basically the next ace decides this game. So we'll see what happens. Actually, the next fight, honestly. Are they a dragon? They're not a dragon. Where the hell are they? They're probably doing some sneaky ass tactics, hiding in a corner or something. I hate when they do that. Team, where are we going? Pushing there, which makes sense. We don't want to lose this tower. Whoa, that got so close to touching me in a place I didn't want to be touched. Let's do this. I need to be in the back. I don't know if you... What? Are you... I don't know if you heard what Olaf just said. But he said, I'm OP, your mom's OP. My mom is OP, guys. She's a pretty cool lady. The ghosts! Well, even with Infinity Edge and Last Whisper, not doing a whole lot of damage to Sion. He's gonna take a while to die. Okay, we either need to go in on this or do other objectives. Stand in here, farming creep waves. Not a good accomplishment. Woo! You tried to ask me a question. Oh shit. What the hell? I didn't even see what happened. Did Vi go in? Okay, there we go. That's what we were waiting for right there. We're waiting for the... anyone, honestly, anyone to extend. And that is going to be the game, ladies and gentlemen. Sion is dead. So all we were waiting for right there, all I was waiting for was to find one of them that just extended just a little too much. And Akali, not Akali, but Nami was the one to do so. And even though she's not necessarily a big damage dealer in the game, if we can turn it into a 4v5, that suddenly changes the game. And it makes Well, it turns it into a victory. So, really, really, really close match. And playing another Heartseeker Ashe. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this game. Do me a favor and comment. Let me know whether or not you like the music in the background. Because I'm actually listening to it as you're listening to it. And I like it. I think it kind of makes me sound less boring, which is a plus. And until next time, guys, this is Blunt Force Llama.